Well, this is a bit impulsive.
If any words that I have spoken have commanded attention, that is only because they find an echo in the breasts of those of every land and of every race who love freedom and are the foes of tyranny.
Britain was a world power. When statesmen like Winston Churchill talked, nations listened.
What kind of a people do they think we are? Is it possible they do not realize that we shall never cease to persevere against them until they have been taught a lesson which they and the world will never forget? It is a poor heart that never rejoices. And if driven to desperate hazards, he attempts the invasion of the British Isles, as well he may. We shall not flinch.
What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of my series of Day in the Life. So, as I said, it's a bit of an impulse trip. So where are we? So we've decided to come over to Chartwell, which is in Westerham in Kent, and this is the former home of Sir Winston Churchill. Always wanted to come here. So this is part of the National Trust, and very similar to the English Heritage as well. You can pay just a small amount every month, and that allows you into access of many, many different places up and down the country. So here we are, Chartwell, Westerham. Beautiful day. We've had to queue up an awful long time to get here. Apparently it's extremely busy, but I can't wait. I've been given permission to record inside the house, so I can't wait for that. So Chartwell, let's get in there and have a look at where Sir Winston Churchill once lived. Chartwell had been the much loved home of the Churchill family since 1922. It was a playground for their youngest daughter and a treasured private country recluse for a very public man. Sir Winston reluctantly left Chartwell in October 1964 due to his poor health and moved to his London flat in Hyde Park Gate. He celebrated his 90th birthday on the 30th of November and then died just a few weeks later on the 24th of January 1965. Later that same year, Lady Churchill decided that she would live in London, and she too left Chartwell in June. Okay, so the first thing that is really apparent, so we've been given a map, But it's huge. This place is absolutely ginormous. Now, I naively thought it was just a house. I did know that there was some grounds here, but I never thought for a second it was anywhere near the type of grounds which is here. So yeah, it's really impressive so far. So we've got about a 40 minute wait until we can actually get into the house. So it is a limited entry, unfortunately. But we have got some beautiful grounds to go around while we wait. And already, I think the actual surrounding area is just absolutely stunning. The National Trust wanted to open the house and gardens to the public as soon as possible due to popular demand. Fortunately, having already owned the property for 18 years before Churchill's death, much of the planning already had been done. Crashing out the skies like a tidal wave down on me. Okay, so we're just heading down to the studio now, which is on the grounds here at Chartwell, and this is where Sir Winston Churchill used to do all of his paintings. So he's quite famous for some of his paintings.
So right behind me now is the studio where Sir Winston Churchill used to do all of his painting. So we've stopped off for a break at Garden Cottage. So we've got, what have you got, Dom?
Flat white.
Dom's got a flat white. I've got a normal cappuccino, is that?
Yep.
Cappuccino.
And a Victoria.
And a big slice of Victoria sponge. And that cost £9. £9.5p. So yeah, it's expensive, but do you know what? When it comes to places like this, it don't really matter, does it, to be fair? No, you're right, absolutely. The setting
here. Other coffee outlets are available.
Everywhere we go.
So as you've just seen, I've just run some footage of the surrounding area to where we are here at the Garden Cottage. Absolutely beautiful. It's very quiet here. I mean, it's very busy. But everybody's just here for exactly the same thing. Weather is perfect. So we're just waiting now. We've got about another 15-20 minute wait before we can gain entrance into the Chartwell House itself. So for now, I'm going to enjoy my coffee and I'm going to enjoy my cake. So one thing I have noticed, and one thing that I do want to say, is that it's very hilly. So you need to be very careful with what you wear. You need to be very careful about if you come with a pushchair. There may well be other paths and so on. People with disabilities or something like that might find it difficult to get around because it's very, very hilly. Again, as you've seen from the shots, you can see that, yeah, you know, we're quite high up and then there's quite a dip where the ponds are. So that's probably I wouldn't call it a negative, but I could imagine that some people would be a little bit disgruntled with that, unfortunately, but it is what it is. They can't obviously change that. But yeah, but all in all, so far, the one place we've been to is the studio. The studio is amazing. Again, you think of the history that's inside that that studio, but it was very small. But then again, I suppose it wouldn't need to be any bigger, would it? I guess there's an awful lot of artwork there as well, which you've seen, fascinating stuff. But yeah, absolutely loving it here so far. It's just so peaceful. Love it. Okay, so what you've seen so far, so this is where we started here, and then we walked down here past this first pond, and then we went down towards Lady Churchill's Rose Garden. We walked past the house, and then we've just gone through the walled garden. So that's the layout of Chartwell House. So as I said earlier, it is absolutely huge. Okay, so we've just got to the front now, where we're actually going to go into Chartwell House. So our allotted time is now here. House is just behind me, as you can see there. There's quite a few people here. But this is it, this is the main attraction. It was decided that the house would be displayed as it was in the 1930s, the era when Winston, Clementine and their four children were all in residence. Apart from minor amendments and additions, the house remained much the same as it was when it was originally opened for public viewing in 1966. It remains a great source of interest and enjoyment to this day. The National Trust worked closely with Lady Churchill, Lady Soames, the Churchill's youngest daughter, and Grace Hamblin, former secretary to Winston, to get the house ready for public opening, and they are mainly responsible for the way we see the house today. The National Trust continues to enjoy a good relationship with the Churchill family. Grace Hamblin even went on to become the first administrator for the Trust when the house opened to the public. Thank you. On the top floor of the house, you'll find the museum and uniform rooms, specially designed to exhibit certain items from the Churchill collection. You can tell what era these rooms were designed in. The artistic influence of the 60s can certainly be felt with the bright colour scheme. The house was never built to be anything more than a home, so naturally the rooms are modest in size and the doorways are quite narrow. One major consideration was how to organise a visitor route that would allow a comfortable visit. As such, you'll find yourselves going from the top floor before descending back down to view the rest of the ground floor. Chartwell is just one of many places that helps to preserve the memory of Winston Churchill. Visit Churchill Central to find out more about the life, leadership and experiences of Churchill and explore the other International Churchill Society partners. So we've just come out of Chartwell House, come out the back there. So I hope you've enjoyed the footage that you've just seen. Fascinating place. Again, I just love the history that is drenched in these four walls. I just love it. But really impressed, really like it. It's a shame that not all of it was open, but I understand that they've got to do renovations and so on, as you can tell by the scaffolding behind me there. But what I've seen so far, this place is beautiful. guess that's going to bring an end to our visit here at Chartwell. Absolutely amazing place, loved it here. It's an absolute no-brainer if you're part of the National Trust. If you're not a member of the National Trust, it's £20 for an adult to get in, which I thoroughly recommend you doing. I'd definitely pay that. Beautiful place, loved it. History, absolutely incredible. Start of the show for me though has to be the grounds. So I had no idea there was just so many grounds here. So the amount of ponds and pools, everyone knows that I like my ponds, I like my fish. Absolutely stunning location. The house itself was amazing. Smaller than I thought it was going to be fair, but really did enjoy it. So so Chartwell House, love it. Okay, so we've just bought this Christmas spirit here, as you can see. So this cost us £19 for this bottle. It's quite heavy. And the contents of this, so what it says is, it's our Christmas spirit is a beautiful blend of ginger, whiskey and Christmas spices, which is cinnamon, cloves, ginger and nutmeg. It sounds lush. It's officially our first Christmas thing of 2022. Really impressed with the gift shop. I wanted to buy a candle there that we saw as well, but that was £18, but that also smelled like Christmas. So that's going to bring an end to today's video. So I hope you've enjoyed it. We've absolutely loved it around Chartwell. Dawn, would you come here again?
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely come here again.
Come back and do the grounds, because there's a bit where the Canadians camped during World War II. So we want to go up and have a look at that.
Do you think it's worth the £20 entry fee if you're not a member of the National Trust?
Oh my God, yeah, it's a full day here. There's so much to do in the house and the grounds and the studio and the tea shops, gift shop, everything.
I think what was perfect as well is that the weather today was absolutely amazing. Probably may even been a little bit too warm. As you can see, I was a little bit overdressed for it because it was quite chilly this morning when we was out. But no, I thought it was absolutely superb. I loved it. It was every bit as good as I thought or hoped it was going to be. The grounds for me was the star of the show. House was great. A little bit smaller than what I thought it would be. But yeah, as I said, the grounds for me were absolutely beautiful. So I hope you thought... No, go on.
I'll say, but I think that's because a lot of the house is under renovation. So in future there may be more to look at, I'm not sure.
Okay, so that's going to bring an end to today's video. So if you've enjoyed today's content, please give the video a thumbs up as well. Please comment down below and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Please help to keep my channel alive. I really do appreciate it. That's it, Chartwell House, done. Another one gone, ticked off. I'm not too sure where we're going to go next. We've got a couple more places lined up. Guys, thank you all so much for watching. I'm going to see you all very soon in the next one. From Dawn and I.
Bye.
We'll see you soon. Take care. See you soon. Bye.
If any words that I have spoken have commanded attention, that is only because they find an echo in the breasts of those of every land and of every race who love freedom and are the foes of tyranny.
Britain was a world power. When statesmen like Winston Churchill talked, nations listened.
What kind of a people do they think we are? Is it possible they do not realize that we shall never cease to persevere against them until they have been taught a lesson which they and the world will never forget? It is a poor heart that never rejoices.